Class. Okay. Good afternoon. In today's session, we have to study about the voltage regulator. So, do you have any idea about the voltage regulator? As the name defines, voltage regulator will regulate the voltage, will give the fixed amount of voltage. So, what we can say by using the voltage regulator circuit, we will get the fixed voltage. These are the outlines which we have to study in today's session. So we are using the batteries. All you guys know about the batteries. We are using the batteries in which we are using the voltage regulator to get DC to DC conversion, but we will get the fixed amount of voltage. So what we can say about the batteries? Batteries often shown on schematic diagram, which will use the source as a DC voltage and which will give us also a DC voltage. Actually, the source is nothing but a DC voltage source, and we are calling this voltage source as a power supply, or we can say it is used as a battery. All are having the same meaning. So you can see here, there are many types of the DC power supply. There are the many types of the power supply. Most are designed to convert high AC voltage into a suitable DC voltage. It means what? We can convert AC into DC because we will require the constant amount of voltage. And a more reliable method for obtaining DC voltage is nothing but it is called as a voltage regulation. So in voltage regulations, we can use transformer, we can use rectifier, we can use filter, regulator to convert the voltage into a fixed amount of voltage. So we can say power supply can be broken into a series of blocks, and their series of blocks means nothing but we can use their transformer, we can use their rectifier, filter, regulator to get fixed amount of voltage to regulate the voltage. And if you see, this is the block diagram for the power supply. So what we can say, if you are giving the AC voltage by using the transformer, you will get the AC voltage, but by using the transformer, we can increase the voltage level or we can decrease the voltage level. It means what? We can say transformer is a device that sets step up or step down the AC voltage provided by wall outlet to get the desired amplitude through the action of the magnetic field. Because if you see in transformer, we use the inductor. Inductor means what? There is a concept of magnetic field. Because according to Faraday's law, if conductor is cut by magnetic field, at that time EMF get introduced. So if you are giving here power supply to the transformer, that time you can increase or decrease that voltage level at the output. And you can give that transform voltage to the rectifier. So by using the rectifier will convert AC voltage into a DC voltage. So firstly, we can see about the power supply. So power supply is nothing but it is a group of circuit like transformer, rectifier, filter, regulator, and load to convert standard AC voltage into a constant or fixed DC voltage. So by using the power supply, we can convert AC voltage into a DC voltage. And we are taking here 120 volt. That's why I have taken here word as a standard AC voltage. दो लोगों ने ऑडियो नहीं ज्वाइन किया है तो तुम्हें कुछ सुनाई तो दे ही नहीं रहा होगा. जस्ट वेट फॉर मिनट, आई एम पुटिंग मैसेज. Okay. So here, if you see, the first block in the power supply circuit is nothing but a transformer, and transformer will convert AC voltage into a required DC voltage. Required AC voltage, not a DC. Transformer will convert AC into a AC, but in the required amount. It means what? If you require higher amount of voltage, it will convert into a higher amount. Or if you require smaller amount of, so it can convert into a smaller amount. Then rectifier. We are giving transform AC voltage to the rectifier. Please mute yourself. What is your name? 593 ABCD 8. You guys are supposed to join class with your name, because at the time of submission period, I will give the term work on depending your attendance, on depending your assessment, then your assignments. So please try to attend your class regular and try to attend your class with your name. Okay. So what we can say, we are giving the transform AC voltage to the rectifier, and that rectifier will convert AC voltage into a pulsating DC voltage. In rectifier circuit, we can use diode. So we can say here, rectifier is nothing but a diode circuit converts AC voltage into a pulsating DC voltage. And then the pulsating DC voltage is only suitable to be used as a battery charger, but not good enough to be used as a DC power supply in the radio, stereo, computer, and so on system. That's why we have to use here regulator to regulate the voltage, because here we will get the pulsating, but we will require the constant amount of voltage that we will get by using the regulator. And here, if you see, we will get the pulsating DC voltage. So again, we can use here filter. What we can say here, a circuit is used. Okay. What we can say here, a circuit is used to reduce the fluctuation in the rectified output voltage. It means what? At the output of the rectifier, we will get the DC voltage, but it is nothing but pulsating. And here, if you see, there are lots of ripple. So what we can say, by using the filter, we can filter whatever output we will require, and we can reduce the fluctuation. So this will be done by using the filter, and this will provide the steadier DC voltage. If you can see here, instead of this pulsating, you will get here steadier DC voltage. And after that, again, if you see, we will require fixed amount of voltage. That's why we are using here regulator. And we are having various types of regulator. We will see one by one. So what we will see, if you see, by using the regulator, we can convert DC voltage into a fixed DC voltage. So what we can see, by using regulator circuit, we will get the constant DC output voltage, because by using the regulator, we will reduce the ripple to the negligible amount, and you will get here fixed amount of voltage. So if you see here, there are different types of a regulator. There is a switching type regulator, there is series and shunt type regulator. In series, we can use zener diode regulator. Again, there is fixed and variable voltage regulator. In fixed, we can use 7XXX series, 7XXX series. In variable, we can use LM317, LM337. So we can see one by one. So what we can see, in series voltage regulator, we can use zener diode, because we know zener diode will work in a reverse bias. So for low current power supply A simple voltage regulator can be made with a resistor and a zener diode that can be connected in series with a that can be connected in series with a resistor. So what we can say, this type of voltage regulator is a series voltage regulator, and zener diode are rated by their breakdown voltage VZ, and maximum power we can denote power by P letter, and we are using here Z for zener diode. So we can see by using here zener diode, you will get the voltage and maximum power, and that power will be 400 milliwatt or 1.3 watt. And by using this zener diode, you will get the fixed output voltage. So what we can say, the zener diode voltage regulator is a series voltage regulator, and it will give the fixed output voltage. Voltage regulations. If you see, there are different parameters you will get in a voltage regulations. You will get line regulations, you will get load regulations, you will get temperature stability. It means what? Instead of changes in the input voltage, instead of changes in the load, instead of changes in the temperature, if there are changes in these three things, irrespective of the changes in input voltage, load, means load ka jo bhi load mein tum connect kar rahe ho, if you are connecting any motor, if you are connecting anything, any electronic circuit at the load, the value of output voltage will not depend on the load. If you are changing the temperature, at that time also, irrespective of the changes in the temperature, the value of output voltage will remain constant. That time you can say we will get the voltage regulations. So what we can say about the line regulations? You will get the constant output voltage irrespective of the changes in the input voltage. It means what? By using the line regulations, you will get the constant output voltage when input voltage varies, when input voltage will change. The purpose of load regulations is also to maintain nearly constant output voltage irrespective of the changes in the load value. So if load varies at that time also, load regulations will give the constant output voltage. Then about temperature stability, I have not written here, but it is also a parameter used in the voltage regulations. So what we can say about the temperature stability? The purpose of the temperature stability is to maintain nearly constant output voltage when the temperature varies. At that time also, that output voltage, you will get the constant irrespective of changes in the temperature. So I have given here formulas for the line regulation. So you will get the line regulation, it is nothing but it is the ratio of percentage change in output voltage with respect to change in the input voltage. We are using here delta sign. Delta is nothing but as a derivative in mathematics. And you can say in science, it is nothing but delta means a change in output voltage with respect to a change in input voltage. And line regulations mathematically calculated as delta V out upon delta V in upon V out into 100. We are calculating line regulation, load regulation in the percentage form. That's why I have written here into 100%. So you will get the same equations. V out, it is in a denominator. So what we can say about the load regulations? If you are connecting any load at the output, but irrespective of the changes in the load value, output voltage will remain constant. If you are changing the value of the load, at that time also, if you see, when we are not connecting any load, if you are changing the value of load, at that time also, if you see, output voltage jo pehle tha, it will remain same. It will not change. So I have written here, no change. So what we can say about the load regulations? A change in the load current due to varying load value. Load value is nothing but we are calling in electronic circuit. Load is nothing but resistance. So I have taken here R here. So a change in load current due to varying load resistance has practically no effect on the value of output voltage. That parameter we can call as a load regulator. So the process in which output value of load voltage will remain constant irrespective of changes in load. Load voltage is nothing but the output voltage. How we can calculate the load regulations? If you see, mathematically, load regulations is defined as it is the ratio of percentage change in the output voltage from no load to the full load. Because what we are saying, if we are changing the value of load, at that time also you will get the constant amount of voltage. So mathematically you can calculate load regulations as VNL minus VFL upon VFL. VFL is nothing but the full load output voltage, and VNL is nothing but the no load output voltage. N is for no, F is for full, and L is for load. So what we can say here, load regulations, you will give the constant amount of output voltage irrespective of changes in load. If there is no load, if there is full load, there will be no effect of load on the output voltage. What happened? Nishiganda, is there any issue? Please mute yourself. Okay. Nishiganda, please mute yourself. You can see here one diagram to see how you will get the constant output voltage. Some power supply manufacturer specify the equivalent output resistance instead of the load regulations. If you are giving here VTH, that voltage is equal to the no load output voltage. And if you are calculating the output voltage at the load value, you will get, according to the voltage divider rule, you will get total voltage. This is nothing but VTH or a VNL into the voltage, the resistance across which we are supposed to calculate the voltage. So RL upon the total resistance. These are in series. So what we can say, you can take in the denominator R out plus RL. So you will get V out equal to VNL into RL upon R out plus RL. So if you equate RFL, the smallest rated load resistance, then you will get value of full load voltage. That will be VFL equal to VNL into RFL upon R out minus RFL. So what we can say, if sometime power supply specify the equivalent output resistance instead of regulations, at that time you will get full load voltage. That will be equal to VNL into RFL upon R out minus RFL. If you are rearranging that equation, you will get how you will get the load regulations. So if you are rearranging that equation, VFL का इक्वेशन था इफ यू आर राइटिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ VNL, तो RFL जो न्यूमरेटर में था वो डिनोमिनेटर में जाएगा. यू विल गेट VNL इक्वल टू VFL इनटू R out माइनस RFL अपॉन RFL. FL इज नथिंग बट द फुल लोड रेजिस्टेंस. सो अगेन व्हाट यू आर डूइंग हियर, इफ यू आर डिवाइडिंग बोथ टर्म बाय द VFL, what you will get? VFL R out minus RFL upon RFL upon VFL minus VFL into 100% if you are calculating the load regulations. Because we know load regulations is nothing but full load voltage. What we have seen here, you can see here. The value of load regulations you will get as VNL minus VFL upon VFL into 100%. And if you are using here resistance as a load, at that time you will get here this equation. You will get here the equations for the VNL. But now we are supposed to calculate load regulation. So load regulations ka equation kya hai? VNL minus VFL. So as it is, I will write this minus VFL upon VFL into 100%. If you are calculating this, you will get here load regulations in the form of resistance, and that will be R out upon RFL into 100%. RFL is nothing but full load resistance, and R out is nothing but the output resistance. If you see, this is the RL and this is the R out. So you will get the value of load regulations in the form of resistance. I have given here some example to solve. What we are supposed to do here, they have given here the input of certain voltage regulator increases 3.5 volt as a result. Output voltage increases by 0.042 voltage. The nominal voltage they have given 20 volt. You are supposed to derive the line regulations in both, in full load and with no load. You will get by using this equation. You will get, you are supposed to use this equation, you are supposed to use for load regulations this equation, you will get the values. Now you can see here the types of regulator. What we are saying, you will get here series regulator, shunt regulator, fixed regulator, switching regulator, variable regulator. Fixed and variable by using the IC. So what we can say, series and shunt regulator, IC regulator and switching regulator. So series and shunt में क्या कर रहे हैं हम? These are nothing but the linear voltage regulator. So the basic two types of the linear voltage regulator are series voltage regulator and the shunt voltage regulator. In series voltage regulator will be connected in series with the load. And if you see about the shunt regulator, if you see here, the shunt regulator is connected in parallel with the load. But yahan pe kya hai? Series mein hai load ke saath. You can see here. So what we can say about the series voltage regulator? In series voltage regulator circuit, series voltage regulator will be connected in series with the load circuit. And in shunt voltage regulator circuit, shunt regulator will be connected in parallel with the load circuit. Load. Op-amp series voltage regulator. If you are using here op-amp series voltage regulator, at that time you can use here, you can use here zener diode. So the two resistors R1 and R2 sense a change in output voltage and it will provide the feedback voltage. The zener detector compares the feedback voltage with zener diode. Because if you see zener diode circuit, I have given here. You can see here. When we are using here, zener diode, the error detector compares the feedback voltage with the zener diode reference voltage. If you see here, we are using here error detector, we are using here control element, and we are using here sample circuit. This is the output voltage. We are giving here unregulated input voltage, and this is the Zener diode. And this is the op amp. This we are calling as the op amp. I have given here. Firstly, you can see here what we can say. We are using here series and shunt voltage regulator. Then, in which we are using in series voltage regulator, we are using control element. We are using error detector. We are using here control element की जगह हम यहाँ पे BJT या फिर MOSFET. You can use here any transistor at reference voltage. What we can use here, we are using here Zener diode and a resistor. Both are in series. Then we are using their op amp. Then we are using their error detector and sample circuit. So what we can say about the control element? The control element will be in series with the load between input and output. The output sample circuit senses the changes in the output voltage. Error detector compares. That will compare, if you see, both are incoming reference voltage and the sample circuit. So sample circuit क्या कर रही है? Output में जो change हो रहा है उसको sense कर रहा है. और reference हमें कहाँ से मिल रहा है? We will get the value of reference voltage by using the Zener circuit, by using the Zener diode and the resistor. So error detector will compare the sample voltage with the reference voltage, and that will causes control element to compensate in order to maintain the constant output voltage, because by using the series voltage regulator we are supposed to regulate the voltage. So you will get here constant output voltage at the output. If you see, this is the circuit diagram for the op amp series voltage regulator. We are using here error detector as the op amp. We are using here transistor as the control element. And in sample circuit, we are using the voltage divider circuit, because we can regulate the voltage by using the divider circuit. जितना हमें चाहिए उसको हम divide कर सकते हैं by using the divider circuit. And we will get the reference voltage by using the Zener diode. So the resistor R1 and R2 senses the change in output voltage, because these are working as a sample circuit, and that will provide that voltage to the this error detector to compare. Then the error detector compares the feedback voltage which you will get from the sample circuit, and it will compare that voltage with the Zener diode reference voltage, and the resulting difference voltage causes the transistor to control the conduction, to compensate the variations of the output voltage and to regulate the output voltage. If you see, you will get the output voltage by using the voltage divider circuit. You will get in bracket 1 plus R1 upon R2 into the total voltage, that is nothing but the Zener diode reference voltage. And we are using here, if you see, we are using here voltage divider circuit. So you will get here output voltage as this equation. If you can see here, we are using here transistor. If you are using transistor series voltage regulator, at that time you can use transistor that will be in series. So what we can say, transistor Q1 is the series control element, and the Zener diode will provide the reference voltage. So it will compare that voltage with the reference voltage, and it will compare that reference voltage with the feedback voltage, and that difference will cause to compensate the voltage and to regulate the voltage. So you will get the regulated output voltage at this point. You can call this as a regulated output voltage. So since we are using here transistor Q1 and we are using here NPN transistor. So you will get output voltage VBE equal to VZ minus VO. VB is nothing but base into emitter voltage. VZ is the, if you see, this is the base, this is the emitter, this is the collector. So you will get here VBE equal to VZ minus VO by using the KVL. So you will get here output voltage equal to VZ minus VBE. The response of pass transistor to change in a load resistance will be as follows. If load resistance will increases, load voltage will also increase. Since the Zener diode voltage is constant, the increases in output voltage will cause to changes in the value of base to emitter voltage to decrease. Because if you see here, you can see here, if you will increase the value of VO, that will cause VBE to decrease, because here VBE is positive and VO is negative. So if you are increasing VO, VBE will decrease. The decrease in VBA will reduces the conduction through pass transistor, so load current will again decreases. So this offset the increase in load resistance and relatively constant load voltage you will get. So what we can say, by using the series voltage regulator, by using the transistor, by using the Zener diode, you will get the series voltage regulator, and irrespective of changes in the load value, irrespective of changes in the input voltage, you will get the constant output voltage. I have given here one example. Determine the output voltage for the regulator. So what we can say here, you are supposed to calculate the output voltage. I have given here all the values for the resistance. I have given here input voltage. So you can take here, I have given here the Zener diode reference voltage as a 5.1 volt. You are supposed to determine the output voltage. You can determine output voltage by using the formula VO equal to 1 plus R1 upon R2 into VZ. You will get the value. Again, if you see, this is the transistor series voltage regulator. So in transistor voltage regulator, we know we can use VBE equal to VZ minus VO. All values I have given here. If you see, VO 11.3 volt. Calculate the output voltage and the Zener current. If you calculate VZ, you are supposed to calculate IZ, because they have given the value for the load resistance also. They have given the value for the IZ as a 36 milliampere, and you are supposed to calculate. At that time, you will get this value. I have written here only solutions. You are supposed to solve that question at your home, and you are supposed to cross-check your answer with this. You will get output voltage as 11.3 volt. You will get the Zener current as a 36 milliampere. You are supposed to use this formula, VB equal to VZ minus VO. Then shunt regulator we will see in next class. If anyone is facing any issue, you can ask me. Now I am taking your attendance. In today's session, we have studied about the voltage regulator. Voltage regulator will convert AC or DC voltage into a fixed DC voltage. There are different types of the voltage regulator, like series voltage regulator, shunt voltage regulator, fixed voltage regulator, variable voltage regulator, switching voltage regulator. Series voltage regulator we have studied. We can use Zener diode and a transistor as a series voltage regulator. Now we can finish our today's class. You guys can leave now. Thank you.